Welcome to the webinar. What we're going to discuss today is knowing and understanding the language of DISC. Because if you understand the language of DISC, it will make you more money, period, end of story. My name is Dr. Paul S. Inselman, and I am a business and success coach, and I just want to welcome you today on your journey. I am a certified professional behaviors analyst, and I am also certified in professional 12 driving forces. What that means is that I am certified to teach you about DISC assessments. I am an entrepreneur. I'm a radio host of How to Build a Better Business, which airs on WSBR Radio every Thursday morning at 10:06 a.m. And I'm also the recipient of the Outstanding Coaches Award in 2014, 2015, 16, and 17. So what we're going to be covering today is, what is DISC? Common behaviors, how to monetize DISC, testimonials, and I'll give you some action steps that you can take today. So, did you ever walk into a room and just not like somebody? Or did you ever walk into a room and you were just captivated by that person? What did it? It was their behavior. You see, you and I and everybody else on this planet possesses certain behaviors that are really germane to us. And what happens is your behavior is either going to cause you to vibrate in a positive level, or it's going to cause you to vibrate at a negative level, meaning that you're either going to be more attractive or less attractive. Think about behavior for a second. Behaviors can cause you to make more money, or behaviors can cause you to lose money. So, welcome to the world of DISC. What is DISC? DISC is the universal language of behavior. Think about it right now. If you knew Spanish, or Italian, or German, or another language, do you think that it would benefit you? Well, if you're a car salesman and your prospect only spoke Spanish, then you would have to agree that knowing Spanish would be quite helpful. If you're out and you see a beautiful woman or a really good-looking guy and they only spoke Italian and you were interested in them, I think you would agree that knowing Italian would be beneficial to you. That's the same thing with DISC. DISC is the universal language of behavior. It's how you do what you do. Now please understand, DISC does not make a person right or wrong or good or bad. And everybody has their behavioral style. But this is the important thing. It's not what style you are, but it's what you do with your style. Now the objectives of behavior are, number one, to identify and understand your style. As I said to you before, did you ever walk into a room and somebody just rubbed you the wrong way? And that was due to their behavior, their style. You see, you have a certain style, and that's the way the world looks at you. Well, also, by understanding DISC and the language, it helps you to identify, understand, and appreciate people who have different styles. And this is the key thing. It teaches you how to adapt to other people's styles. And this is the key to increased and improved sales. This is the key to managing your employees. And this is really the key to having successful personal relationships. So DISC, DISC. We are made up of a combination of the D's, the I's, the S's, and the C's. And let's take the first part of that D. D equals dominance. It's how you address problems. A high D is quick to anger, they're very demanding, and they're egocentric. They're a very, very driving personality, and they're ambitious. Think of Donald Trump. Now, tips in speaking to somebody who is a high D would be to provide solutions, not opinions.
And you moment, you will receive a text back.
Better present them quickly. DISC. The I portion of that is influence. It's how you handle situations involving people. High I people are optimistic. They're trusting. They're inspiring. They're magnetic. And they're very enthusiastic. Think about Oprah Winfrey. Tips in speaking to a high I person would be to be very positive, and you have to get them to commit to a plan. D-I-S-C. The S in DISC is steadiness. It's how you demonstrate pace and consistency. A high S person is very consistent. They're not expressive. They're very relaxed. These people are extremely resistant to change. They're very passive and they're very patient people, and they are extremely loyal. Think of Mr. Rogers. Tips to speaking to somebody who is a high S would be to show sincere interest, and you have to show them how to minimize the risks. D-I-S-C. The C in DISC is compliance. It's how you react to procedures and constraints. A high C person is extremely detailed-oriented. They are worrisome. They're very careful. They are extremely dependent. They're cautious, and they are very conventional. Think about Mother Teresa. And tips for speaking to somebody who is a high C is to prepare your case well in advance, be direct, and you have to supply them with lots of data to support your argument. Now, for every high D, I, S, and C, there is also a low. And I'm not going to go into those characteristics now. I just want to point it out that you understand that there are two parts to this language. There is the high part and there is the low part. And also what I want you to understand is that you are a mixture, and so is everybody else, of D's, I's, S's, and C's. So what if Fortune 500 companies know that you don't? Well, Fortune 500 companies are interested in one thing and one thing only. What is it? It's profit. And how do they do it? A, they grow their business, and B, they decrease waste. You see, think about in a hiring situation. Most businesses hire for a task. Let's think about a chiropractor who's looking for a chiropractic assistant. Oh, you can answer the phone, you can use an appointment book, you know the computer, and you know our system. Great, you're hired. Why do people get fired? Typically, they get fired because of their behavior. If they came in on time, that's a behavioral trait, they'd still have a job. If they didn't cruise Facebook on my time, they would still have a job. If their boyfriend or girlfriend didn't come in and hang around, they'd still have a job. Those are all behaviors. So what Fortune 500 companies know and do is that to limit waste, you must decrease employees leaving. You see, if you hire an employee and they stay for a week or two or 3 months and then they get fired or they quit, that is a real loss of emotional energy. It's a real loss of economics, of money, and it's a real loss of time. So what Fortune 500 companies do is they match the behavior of the person to the behavior and task of the job. Let me give you an example. If you are looking for a receptionist, would you want Oprah Winfrey sitting at your front desk, or would you want Mother Teresa sitting at your front desk? If you answered Oprah Winfrey, you'd be right. You see, Mother Teresa is a wonderful person, or was a wonderful person, but you want somebody who's very warm, somebody who's very people-oriented, to be sitting at your front desk. Mother Teresa would be much better with details, would be much better, you know, working kind of in an alone setting. So it's very important to match the job to the personality of the hire. Now, don't take my word for it. Look at the screen. There are 100,000 companies that use DISC assessments with their employees and their potential hires every single day. So how do you monetize DISC? Remember, D-I-S-C. So let's say that you're a car salesman. And let's say that after you learned the language of DISC, you are able to, and you would be able to, assess that person in 7 to 30 seconds. In other words, in 7 to 30 seconds, you would be able to tell, in this example, that your prospect is a high S. Well, if you are a high D personality type, dominance, and most car salesmen are, most people in sales are, they're drivers, they're very dominant. What happens is, if you start to use pressure techniques or sales-oriented techniques with an S, a high S, you will lose that sale every single time. So it's not that their personality type or their behavior is wrong. Remember, DISC doesn't assess right or wrong. It's how they look at the world. It's how they communicate to the world. And if you want to have more closings, if you're in sales, then it's going to be imperative for you to blend your style to theirs. So if you're a car salesman and you know that somebody's a high S, they're not interested in, wow, you look great in that car. Oh, wow, smell that new car smell. They're not interested in that. What they're interested in is, look at the safety features of this vehicle. Look at the airbags, how many of them. Look at the latest safety, and not into style. On the other hand, let's say that you are an insurance salesman, an insurance broker, and you know that your client that you've assessed in 7 to 30 seconds is a high D. Well, you better be real quick and short and sweet and to the point. And you better have a very clear, thought-out plan and why it benefits that person. So my point is, the way you monetize this in business, if you're in sales, is by knowing who that person is sitting before you, you will have a much higher close rate. The way you monetize this, if you're an employer, is that you will now use this to match the behavioral characteristics along with the tasks that the job requires. That will end up having you have much less turnover, much better employees, much better for the long haul. The way you monetize this in your personal life is by knowing and understanding how your wife or husband communicates will definitely make for a stronger relationship. We have many, many clients who have literally saved marriages because they understood D, I, S, and C. The way you're going to monetize this in your personal relationship is also by understanding your kids. When you understand how your kids view the world and how you need to talk to them in their language, you'll be much more they will be much more easily motivated, and you will have a much less stressful time in dealing with your family. Let's go over some testimonials. This is from a client of mine. His name is Mark, and Mark is an insurance broker. And he was coaching with me for a while, and he was getting some difficulty in closings. And I suggested to him that we start to do some DISC assessments and that I teach him the language of DISC. And he stopped me and he said that, no, I already learned DISC. I already took an assessment. He took a free assessment online, and he got a couple of reference books. And he said, you know, I know that I'm a high D, and I've been using this in my business. And I started to ask him some questions to test his knowledge. And I said to him, hey, Mark, respectfully, you don't know DISC. Well, he got so offended because he thought that I was trying to upsell him, to sell him to, you know, for me to teach him DISC. And when I explained to him exactly what I was doing and why, and again, in his language, he said, okay, you know, I see that. Let's do it. And the results speak for themselves. He says, you know, I now understand and agree with you. I didn't know DISC, and thank you for educating me on the proper way of using this extremely powerful tool. The results, we taught him DISC at the end of 2016. In 2017, coincidentally, he had his record of record years. Mark, thank you so much for sharing that testimonial. This next testimonial is from Adam Cherry, who is an extremely amazing entrepreneur. He's the president of Tappet Technology. If you need any kind of app created for your business, you definitely want to give him a call. Now, I've been coaching him for a long, long time, and he's referred to us from another client. And basically, what we've done with him is we have created a goal structure with him and have developed procedures for him to really follow the yellow brick road step by step. And by his doing this, he has really done exceptionally well, not only with this business, but other businesses that we coached him through. And we're so happy to have him as a client. And Adam, thank you so much for this awesome testimonial. Nicholas is another amazing client. He owns an advertising agency, and he had revolving chair syndrome. What I mean by revolving chair syndrome is he would hire somebody, and they would leave just as quickly as they were hired. And he was getting extremely frustrated and extremely burnt out. And I said to him, you know, you can't lead others if you can't lead yourself. Let me teach you the language of DISC. And more importantly, let me teach you how to use DISC. So we did, and we learned it, and he's done really well with it. And the results for him are he doesn't have revolving chair syndrome anymore. He gets employees that stay with him. Now, we had taught him DISC years ago, and I don't remember the last time that he had any employee turnover other than one person who left because her husband got relocated to California, and that's why she left. But otherwise, his employees have stayed, and he's been extremely, extremely happy. On the money front, because he's not going through personnel on that revolving chair, he has certainly eliminated that waste portion, and his business also is growing exponentially. So, are you ready to change your financial future? Are you ready to improve your personal relationships? If you do, then I would recommend that see if you qualify for us to teach you DISC. You see, we don't teach DISC to everyone. You have to meet certain qualifications. To see if you qualify, just go to the button below this video that says request a free consultation. Click on that and follow the instructions to schedule for your free and no obligation telephone consultation. After your appointment is made, you're going to receive via email a detailed business profile, and it's going to come from a company called SignNow. You can fill that profile out in about 10 minutes, and you can do it right online. On the day of your free telephone consultation, we will discuss your business profile and will determine if you are a candidate to learn the language of DISC. If you are a candidate, we'll determine together exactly how DISC and DISC assessments will change your personal and business life forever. Does that sound exciting? I have to tell you, we are so touched to be able to help so many people just like you. People who are watching this webinar saying, I don't know, you know, is this going to help me? Do I really want to spend the money? All the people that we've helped have been where you are. And when you're ready to take that leap, and if you qualify, we'll be excited to help you too. So I want to thank you for taking these few important moments to learn about the language of DISC. And we look forward to helping you achieve the financial security, the financial freedom, and to enjoy the life that you deserve. If you have questions and you want to email me, feel free. My email address is up on the screen there. And the website is creativecoachingllc.net, which you're already into now. And you can poke around. There's lots of free information on this website of webinars and written articles and blogs, etc., etc. Feel free to avail yourself of all the information. If you have questions and you want to reach me in the office, the phone number is at the bottom of your screen, 888-201-0567. And I thank you so much for joining us, and I wish you much success on your financial career.